Hey book lovers, Kaylee here. Welcome back to the Enchanted Library, and it is the start of a new month, which means it's time to wrap up August. I'm so excited that it's finally September. It is officially my birthday month. So in the month of August, I didn't read the crazy amount that I did back in July, which was good because I needed to take it a little bit easy after that, 13-14 book month. I am so excited to share them with you, so let's get into it. I'm gonna start off with a book that I had on my shelves since 2015 when it came out, because the initial idea of the book really intrigued me, but for whatever reason, I just wasn't in the mood for it. But now I am honestly so into this series, I cannot wait to read the next one. But I ended up picking up finally Legacy of Kings by Eleanor Herman. So this is book one in the Blood of Gods and Royals series, and it is a reimagining with some historical accuracies and inaccuracies of Alexander the Great. Eleanor Herman essentially researched so much about Alexander the Great, and a lot of the things that happen in this book in terms of battle and in terms of the entire royal family and that sort of thing are actually true, but she switched it up a bit and turned it more into a fantasy, and she's connected the dots of all of these different things that have happened through a fantastical way. This book has multiple points of views, and I honestly loved each and every one of them. I was so on board for each character that I got introduced to, and I can't wait to read more about their stories because they all have some connection to Alexander the Great, whether they know it or not at the time. I will admit, probably my favorite character out of all of them is Katarina. I feel like that's a fair amount of people's would typically be their favorite, but I don't care. I absolutely love her arc and I love her story the most, but I didn't find myself trying to rush through any points of views in particular in order to get to one that I liked the most. They each had something to do. It wasn't stagnant time in this book, and I really appreciated that. There's a lot of action, there's a lot of magic, there is a lot of politics, but it's all so amazing, and I love the time of Alexander the Great, and I need to finish this series real quick because I absolutely adored it. And I did end up giving this book a 3.5 to a 4-star rating, just because there were a couple things that I could tweak here and there that would make it even better, but I feel like the second book in the series is just gonna up the game even more, and it's just gonna continue to do so as the series progresses. So this was the first book that I ended up reading in August. The next two books that I read kind of go hand in hand because it's the first and the second in a series, so I'm only really going to talk about the first book because I don't want to spoil anybody. But the book that I ended up reading next was The Black Witch by Laurie Forrest. Now, I know I've been talking a lot about this book recently, but honestly, I really enjoyed it. I ended up giving it a 4 out of 5 stars. I'm doing a book talk on it soon because I just need to talk more about this series, and I also wanted to touch on some of the reviews that it had been given in the past, and I'm just gonna premise by saying that those reviews, while everybody's reviews and points of views are valid, I don't think that a lot of the negative reviews actually read the book. I feel like they just sort of scanned it or heard what other people had said and drew their own conclusions, because the negative reviews on this make absolutely no sense to me. Like, it just does not make any sense. This story is such an interesting idea, and I absolutely love that it gave me Harry Potter vibes, and also the fact that it had female empowerment, and there was also a lot about politics, and there's just so much that goes on in this story. I will admit it did take me probably a good 100-150 pages to really get into it, but once I did, I was so game. Even after I put this book down and I finished it, it just kept getting better and better in my mind because all of the things that I kept thinking about, all of the points that it touched on, were just so well done that even after I put the book down, I kept thinking about it. Because I just kept thinking about all of the real world things that it touched on, and it did it so nicely that I just think everybody should read this book. Also, pick it up soon because the sequel, The Iron Flower, comes out on September the 18th. So I read this book also in August, and I gave it again 4 out of 5 stars because it was a really exciting follow-up to The Black Witch, and the ending just blew my mind. So definitely pick up this series. It is really good, and I don't think you'll be disappointed. especially if you love like a high fantasy, magical university type situation. And the last book that I picked up is actually a reread for me, because on Twitter, for basically the entire month of August, I have been inundated with pictures of the new updated cover for this book, and I just had to pick it up because it's not the 10th anniversary of this story, but I still ended up really enjoying it as much as the first time I read it 6 years ago, and that was Grave Mercy by Robin Lefebvre. So this book I feel like so many people have already read, so I don't think I need to get too much into it, but it is basically following a nunnery of assassins. So this story follows Ismay after she has recently been married off to a guy who she really does not like. Her father basically just wants to be rid of her, and he ends up marrying her off to this guy who ends up being abusive on the night of their wedding and beating her up really bad and throwing her into a cell, essentially. And in the night, someone comes and takes her away, and they end up taking her to this nunnery, which is actually an assassin's guild for women who have been touched by the Saint Mortain. And the point of this nunnery is to just do the will of Saint Mortain. And that means killing people who have been touched with a particular mark. And the only people who can see this mark are the assassins. As her training is coming to a close, Ismay gets sent on her first mission, where she ends up running into, I'd say, an aristocrat. And she ends up running into him twice, and they end up being thrust together to infiltrate the court because there are people who want to assassinate the queen, and it's such a wild ride. I absolutely love this book. I know it's the first in a series, but for whatever reason, I didn't end up picking up the rest of the series. I think I was just so happy with the way that this book ended that I didn't really want to reopen up the world, because I just think that even as a standalone, this book is amazing. Eventually, I might pick up the next two in the series, but for now, I'm surprisingly happy that this works as a standalone for me. But I definitely recommend this if you have not read it. It's got fierce women in it who can take care of themselves. It's got a bit of romance, it's got some magical elements, and it's a really good book, and I'm really happy that I picked it up. I was just in the mood to reread it after, like I said, seeing all those tweets and seeing the new covers that are being released for the series, and I'm happy that I reread this. So let me know in the comments down below if you have read any of these books or if any of these books interest you. And don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel for more content. I do put out new videos every weekend and a few videos sprinkled throughout the week here and there if I have some bonus content. I am filming a lot of videos coming up because, like I said, it is my birthday month, so I'm deciding to have a little bit of a theme with my additional videos this month, and I'm really excited about it, and I hope that you guys are too. And until next time, keep reading.